in response to an article published in the Tuscaloosa News explaining that most Alabama Republican leaders say they are voting for Roy Moore despite the numerous sexual misconduct allegations against him, Tuscaloosa News intern Molly Catherine Walsh shared details of her own interaction with the accused child molester on Twitter. Ms. Walsh, who was 20 years old at the time, recounts her decidedly uncomfortable and wholly unprofessional encounter with the sexual deviant currently running for the U.S. Senate in Alabama. If president is any indicator, Moore is certain to deny ever meeting her, much less acknowledging the veracity of her accusation. Roy Moore has been mired in scandal since the Washington Post published a bombshell report in which four women, a number that has since grown precipitously, stepped forward to accuse Roy Moore, at the time a district attorney in his 30s, of engaging in sexual behavior while they were between the ages of 14 and 18 years old. The story was corroborated by over 30 sources. In his desperation to discredit his numerous accusers of sexual misconduct and pedophilia, Moore recently claimed at a campaign event that his victims are not to be trusted because real victims would never allow their faces to be seen in the news. "I've represented many victims in cases such as this. I have not seen one who wanted her picture posted on national TV, especially in a political advertisement. The truth is, this is not really odd at all. It is simply dirty politics and it's a sign of the immorality of our time," Moore said. To be clear, this is an accused child molester lecturing people about immoral behavior. Moore is alleging that every single one of his accusers is lying because no true victim of sexual misconduct could possibly want her picture posted on national TV. In other words, he has decided that real sexual assault and rape victims are only found in the shadows, and as soon as they speak up, their credibility is decimated. How convenient that would be for people like him. Even Trump, in a move as shameful as it is unsurprising, endorsed the Republican Senate hopeful. "I've represented many victims in cases such as this. I have not seen one who wanted her picture posted on national TV, especially in a political advertisement. The truth is, this is not really odd at all. It is simply dirty politics and it's a sign of the immorality of our time," Moore said. To be clear, this is an accused child molester lecturing people about immoral behavior. Moore is alleging that every single one of his accusers is lying because no true victim of sexual misconduct could possibly want her picture posted on national TV. In other words, he has decided that real sexual assault and rape victims are only found in the shadows, and as soon as they speak up, their credibility is decimated. How convenient that would be for people like him. On the eve of tomorrow's election, Ms. Walsh deserves to have her account heard, and the people of Alabama deserve to know all of the disgusting facts about a man who may represent them in the United States Senate. Even Trump, in a move as shameful as it is unsurprising, endorsed the Republican Senate hopeful.